Right, good morning everyone. Welcome back to the GD and Son channel. I hope everyone's having a great day. I'm a little bit bunged up today. Oh, bloody hay fever season is starting to kick in. Although it hasn't been that bad, just over the last few days I've really started sneezing a lot, uncontrollably. I just have these moments, and I can only put it down to hay fever because I feel pretty good. I've got no sort of cold symptoms or anything like that. So yeah, I do suffer a little bit with hay fever. Don't get as bad as I used to when I was a kid. When I was a kid, I used to get bulgy eyes and, you know, throat was all swollen up and everything. Yeah, I had to live on Pyrum, but now, you know, sort of don't really get it that often. Just every now and again, so. The joys of the summertime approaching. So I hope you all enjoyed the last video. A little bit long-winded, I know, but people do like to see footage inside the scrapyard. That's why I kept all that in. So hopefully it wasn't too long for you, and you all enjoyed it. Yeah, what we've got on today, basically, I'm coming out this morning to do a little bit of scrapping. I'm picking Billy up about 8 o'clock. We've got to go and do a waste removal job over at a care home. Not the usual care home we go to, it's another one that we started doing a little bit last year. We've done one job privately for this woman at her house, and then we've done one for her at the business. She was really happy with the service, so she's carried on using us, and she's called us up. It's basic furniture, there's a load of old furniture that's going inside the care home. They're obviously upgrading their stuff, and she's asked if we can come down and collect the old bits. So that's what we've got planned for 10 o'clock this morning. We could get there a little bit earlier. Hasn't got to be done at 10 o'clock, but I've given her about 10 or a little bit earlier as a time. Whether or not I'll go to the scrapyard today, I don't know, because haven't got much on the back at the minute, and unless I was to find like loads of scrap, then it's not really worth my time to just drive down there with, you know, 40 pound on the back of the truck. So I'll probably just leave it and just chuck it all into my mum's garage as storage, and it'll be there for me tomorrow. And then all I can do is just go around collecting some scrap tomorrow, go to the garage, empty it out, take it all down one hit, and save the hassle of driving all the way down there, you know, wasting diesel, not for a lot of money. So anyway, let's crack on with the scrapping first thing and see what is about. Couple of little scrappy bits. Pretty cool actually, isn't it? They've got one wheel at the front. Didn't have they before attaching onto a Segway or something like that. So you can make it go forwards and backwards. Turn the Segway into like a little go-kart. Not that I've got a Segway, mind you, so it ain't no good to me, but just looked pretty decent. Anyway, yeah, not really much to report at the minute. It's quite quiet out here today. Not a lot of scrap about, so I'll just continue to do what I'm doing. Hopefully we'll have a bit of luck, and if not, then oh well, we'll carry it on till tomorrow. So let's keep going. Check on this old barbecue. Rusty as hell, that one. And I've got my jumper wet. No. Right, I've just been around the co-op, getting my daily dose of energy. Yeah, not really been much about. I've had a little scan around a few areas, and it's only a few little small bits I'm picking up, so I've got to go and get Billy within the next sort of 20 minutes anyway, so I'm going to wrap it up there and just leave the scrapping for today. What we're going to do is I've got to go and pick up some rubbish from my mum's garage. So what I'm going to do is swap the rubbish and the scrap over. So whatever scrap I've got in the back here, I'll just put it in the garage, put all the rubbish on, and then hopefully everything goes to plan. I'm back out doing scrapping again tomorrow. I should be out for quite a few hours tomorrow. Going to be trying out a few different locations as well, so I can obviously go around and get the scrap out of the garage tomorrow to fill the van up a little bit more. Yeah, because we've got quite a busy day on today. It is only the one job, but it's quite far out. We've got to do a lot of driving to get out there. I've priced it quite well because of that. And we've got to go out there, obviously pick all the furniture up, and then it's quite a long drive to the actual waste transfer station as well, because we can only kind of use one station at the minute, because I did have a couple of stations I used to use, depending on what area I was in, but one of them's jumped their prices right up, and I mean really, really high, so not going to be using that one if I don't have to. So I'm going to actually drive a little bit further back to the place where the prices are a little bit cheaper. So yeah, that's the plan for now. I'll see you all in a little bit. We'll go around and grab Billboy and let's make this happen. Right, so we've just got down here now to the care home. We're going to load stuff on. Ideally, we're not right next to it, which is what we wanted to get to, because it's by a skip. But yeah, there's a scaffold lorry in the way. They're up on the top of the roof somewhere, so I'm not going to disturb them. And then this car park is just massively busy. It wasn't this busy last time. The stuff was over there on the grass. So anyway, I'm going to get a pole set up. Hopefully you'll be able to see everything, but if the load starts getting too high, obviously something might block the camera. So I've got Big Bad Bill with me. He's going to be helping us out today. Yeah, we'll get it all loaded on and we'll take it off to the tip. So see you in a bit. Right, so we've just finished in that job now, a little bit later than what we'd usually want to be. It's now coming up 10:30, about an hour to the recycling centre. Basically, the chairs in there was two chairs which weighed a freaking ton, what I thought they did. They've got this like metal framework, they're the ones, the recliners that come up, and all the weight is in the frame, so it was well worth taking the 10 minutes to strip them apart and get the metal framework off, because now we've got obviously a bit of metal to go to the scrapyard, and we've also lightened the load from our dump. So yeah, we're gonna head down there now, about an hour. I'm not sure how much of that you saw. I'll probably cut a load of it out, because obviously we did keep stopping to try and get this framework off. But I'll try and piece together some clips of us loading it on, and then we'll catch you back down at the recycling yard and we'll get rid of all this rubbish. So see you there. Right, so we're just going to get tipped off now. Normally we go down the other end, but because we've got mainly sofas and that on, they've said they ain't got to handle it twice, just unload all the bulky items into here, any wood we've got, just keep it separate, and then the metal we're obviously taking with us anyway. So yeah, happy days. Right, so we're just going to get tipped off now. Normally we go down the other end, but because we've got mainly sofas and that on, they've said they ain't got to handle it twice, just unload all the bulky items into here, any wood we've got, just keep it separate, and then the metal we're obviously taking with us anyway. So yeah, happy days. Chairs, I think, go in here as well. No, I don't think so. Right, let's try and start chucking all the wood down on this side, Bill. Do you want the wood down here? Let me forget my broom, Bill. Where do you want all this stuff, mate? Where do you want all this stuff? Down on the side here?
Yeah.
Under that side, Bill. No. Okay.
So that's a lot of plasterboard.
Oh shit. Yeah, I'll just move out a little bit. Right, let's go and pay the bill. Right, so that's us done for the day then. We've finished in the tip now. Got all that stuff unloaded, kept the metal on. So metal we got out of the last job was an oven. We got a stainless steel sink, which wasn't actually part of the deal, but it was buried in the skip. So I thought I'd have that, and also had a nice set of brass taps on there as well. So I couldn't leave that behind. And yeah, it's just mainly after that, the metal from the chairs. Now, I don't know if any of you have had recliner chairs that you've took the metal base off, but they're so heavy. I reckon that's probably took down our load that we took in the recycling center. That must have took off about 50 kg. It really, really is heavy stuff. So yeah, we had two of them chairs. Brilliant, really happy with that. So yeah, just want to say, if you did like the video today, I know it's only a short one, but please smash that like button because it really does help me out. And subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed, and I'll see you all probably tomorrow for a scrapping video. So take care, everyone.